about your character and the changes that we're going to see this season.
So Bran obviously has lost his legs and his family and his home, and frankly it's been a pretty bumpy, horrible ride for him. But what he does have is this interesting mystical side to his character, and he can warg into animals, and he in season four Bran is very much chasing this, and there is some kind of calling that's telling him he has to go somewhere to find out how important his power is and what it can do.
How do you handle that whole magical aspect of the show, and how do you make it real for yourself?
I mean, what's great about the show, and David and Dan have said this, is the fact that magic is sort of as it is in our world. Many of the characters are skeptics. They don't believe in it, and they think, oh, well, the dragons died hundreds of years ago, or the White Walkers don't exist. And that's what makes the magic really interesting, and I feel really lucky to be one of the characters who does get to have a magical element.
And how did you get cast for the show?
I just went to a local drama group. It was like a million billion to one chance. It was a real... I found football too cold on Saturdays, so I was looking for something else to do, so I did drama, and they were doing an open casting, so I went up for an audition, and then another, and then one more, and there was a long gap, and then I got the role, and I had no idea what it was going to be, or how I'd now be standing in New York doing all this, so yeah.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
What has been the most surprising or amazing experience you've had so far involved in this project?
I think doing things like this, coming to New York or LA, and I mean, I would never have even dreamed of even thinking of doing something like this before ever getting involved in acting. So to be able to do this, I feel hugely privileged.